Hey there, how's it going? This is Akash here and you're watching Tech Infinity. So after a very long wait, we finally have official Android Pie on the LG V30. So in this video, we'll be having a look at this particular ROM, what kind of new features this ROM is offering and that kind of stuff. So this isn't really a full review of this ROM because I've been using this for, I think, a couple of days, and that really isn't enough to comment on battery life, performance, and really everything. So this is basically more of a first impressions video from me. So without further ado, let's get started. So this is the network interface. So this is pretty standard stuff out here. Nothing new, it seems. So the major thing about this update obviously is that it is running on an Android 9 Pie. And that is the latest official upgrade from Google as of now until Android Q drops. So this is pretty generic stuff, nothing new here. Now under sound profiles, let us see what is there. Okay, pretty standard stuff. Oh, and on the bottom you can clearly see that these are the navigation gestures that I'm using here. So this comes with Pie, so it's really nice to see them. And I'm using the inbuilt screen recorder here. So that's pretty cool. And I really love this inbuilt screen recorder because it is able to record the internal audio of the phone. So if you're playing, say, any game like PUBG or playing any song or something and you enable screen recording, it will even record the internal sound, that is the sound that is coming out, that generally comes out of the speaker, that will be recorded. So that's pretty cool for people who generally like to use, to record gameplay of, say, maybe PUBG. So let's move on. Okay, nothing majorly new here that I can notice. So this is where things will change. So let me quickly show you. I'm using the Nova launcher here and that works flawlessly, but let me just use the home and app drawer that comes from LG. So as you can see here, this is the app drawer. And you even have the Google feed on the left. So that's pretty dope. Okay, so I'm trying to hold and press it. Okay, so you have stuff like app, trash, widgets, home screen settings is also there. So from here also you can change what kind of launcher you want to use. You have wallpaper option and even have panorama and this kind of thing. Okay, so yeah. Okay. And you have icon shape options, rounded, cylinder, original. Okay, so I think I like this one. You have the Google feed option, you can customize the grid. You have search options, home screen lock. Okay, so that's pretty general stuff out here. So let me go back into the settings. Okay, you have wallpaper and theme options. So do note that theme will not be working, that used to work on Android Oreo. So you need to download newer Android theme. So I'm using the LG UX8 black theme on this one. Okay. And okay, let me just jump in. Okay, now we have the always on display options here. So as you can see, there are quite a few options. You have the option of brighter display, timeout, and this is the digital clock option here. As you can see, there are several. Okay, so these are newer things that I'm seeing here. As you can see here, this is new stuff. So just have a look at it. It kind of looks pretty cool. Okay, let's have a look at this one. So a couple of new watch faces here and it kind of looks pretty cute. You have the dual clock option. I'm not interested in that. You can add a signature. So here comes my name. Let us basically have a look at the new pictures. Okay, so this astronaut picture was already there. I think most of these pictures were already there, but yeah, I see a couple of new ones. Okay, no, now there are a lot of new ones. Okay. I'll just quickly swipe through them. You can have a look at them. Okay, you even have an option. Oh, you even have an option of GIF. Oh, this is very cool. I don't think it was there earlier. Wow, that's amazing. Okay, I'm getting sidetracked here. Let me go back. You already had the option to change the screen resolution earlier as well. You have display size. I'm using smaller option. So you can change that. You have HDR video effect on some videos. So far we have seen mostly standard stuff. And here you can change the home touch buttons. I can either use these buttons, but I obviously like this gesture thing. So you can reverse it, as you can see. Let me use the standard one. Okay, you have the option for color as well. As you can see here, it is changing slightly. I like the black one, so I'll just keep that. And you even have the option of apps where you can hide this thing. So that was pretty much it here. Okay, you even have something like floating bar. I think it was already there, previous version as well. And just like previous versions, I'll probably not use that. Okay, so you have a few font options here as well, and you can even add some fonts. You can change the size of the fonts. Let me make them a bit bigger. So as you can see here, you even have some gaming tools, game graphic customizations. Now that you have already seen PUBG here, let me tell you that I noticed that PUBG performance is better than what I had on Android Audio. So that's great to see for me. Okay, and another great feature is this dual app. So I can install copies of WhatsApp and Telegram if I want to use a secondary account on these apps. So WhatsApp, you can basically use only one account on the app, the official app, so I can install a second instance of WhatsApp. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.